Shiva Chidambaram. I am working as a chief librarian at I have taken a charge on, I think, January 2014 as a chief librarian at All India Institute of Medical Science. So I would like to mention, introduce my institute. If you come to Delhi, then everybody knows that AIIMS are the local name of medical staff. This is the AIIMS is a, not only a medical this thing, they are doing research. They are a research institute and they are a teaching institute and they are doing for the most important is they are doing for a patient care. There are four aspects. It is a main aspect of this institute. And you can see that number of people are working. There are 672 faculty members are there. And every year more than 50 PhDs are produced from there because they have pure science allied with medicine. And there are near about 100 senior residents are appointed every year and then after consecutive 2 years they will be going for further this thing. And apart from that they also have the MD courses. Near about 52 departments they have. And then library is 2,700 square feet, 2 floors. It was like half a century library, old library. And it has, I will show you the next slide. It has a footfall of, even today, library has 350 people on an average every day. And it is open 24/7. And when I joined there, then the interview board, there are 7 professors, there are doctors. They were told that your objective should be our journals. We have enormous journal collection. That has to bring it to our table. This was the challenges they had given to me. So then, what? When I joined there, then I did a survey with the 52 departments, HODs. I wrote a letter to them. We have this list of journals. And now almost all the journals are in the online. So now you choose the option which has to be in the online, which has to be in the print. After 15 days, I got a 48 department reply. They are thoroughly analyzed and they said that first very stop print, go for only online. Then second, they had given the objective, they had gone through the journal we had given in the subject wise. They said that you can add some more journals in the our subject area and they had given the journal name also. Then after finishing that, then we had taken a serious step and then we had gone for the online, this one. So you see this collection of this library, Dr. Bibi Dixit library, because I found the director name, and it has a books about 73,000. And see the journals by volume is around 75,000. It is engulfing the major collection of books and the journals are there. And I already told you that is a 2700 square feet only. There are 2 floors in the library. So we have seen what is there. There is a traditional library. They said that everything access is an asset of the institute. So we should not take anything. There is no widow policy, anything for that. Because that library is not even connected to a government, to the academic session, academic library state. So then we decided, then we check up with our faculty, senior faculty members. So we thought, let us go for a back volumes and we, whatever we know needed, like abstract and index in journals. Medical, you may know that index medical is that time it was a very, very useful tool. So we thought we will remove that and we will put it in the offsite center. Those which are not used, unused, those journals we can shift to the offsite center and then we will make that space. So this is how that we made it and the first of the print and online journals we got it. And this is our collection. You see that different kind of publishers and this publisher, this slide why I am showing is, you see that the major journal is society based journal. There are 381 journals. You know that in medical science, there are each subject they have the society. So that Society Channel is much more useful for the people, and this has their own website, and they have the different categories, and then we have to show these journals. So when we decide for stop printing and online journals, we thought how we can go for the access. So first we put that entire list in the A2Z list in the website, and earlier it was just for the list. Then we put the A2Z list with open URL, and then we put all these things database also include. Then we decided to go for a discovery service, and we selected the discovery service for purposely journals only. It has to do for the linking of our collection, because 1500 journals, they have to create the collection, and plus these are all the point of care databases that they have to give the link, so people can come and the doctors can access in the single point search. So whatever the source, really library has it. So this was win-win situation. It was going on that. This was, I was telling, index medicals and everything we had shifted to the offsite center. And then this space has been converted as an e-reading hall. It is 24/7 open now. And it has Wi-Fi facility, thin client they have for browsing the e-resources, and sufficient PowerPoint facilities. This has been, earlier it was used as faculty cabin for 11 people, 11 faculties. Now it is used for near about 80 people can sit at a time and read this, use this hall. And searching, which I was telling that, how they will go for that. First they will give the journals in the midline, and then they will go for the text. These are all feedback analysis which we had edited before going for the discovery. So then we come to the single point search through EBSCO, this one, discovery service. And this was given the economic viability to the management now. Easy access facility through the remote access. And it is a device-free access. Doctor can use their iPad there, and then encourage the use of single point search through this comparison and all by our staff. And it is really useful for the return on investment showing to the institute. Thank you very much. Thank you for giving me the opportunity for the organization. Thank you, sir.
Thank you very much. I now.